Here we are in Sydney Taronga Zoo. Let's go and see the animals. Giraffe. Zebra. Meerkat.
Not where we're going, Cisco. He is going off to check the other sides of the exhibit here, see if any of his friends are in those areas. All right, Cisco, you know the script. Keep on going, you can do it, buddy. All right, on the count of three, jump, Cisco. I'll catch you all in. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Oh, I thought you all did an amazing job. I'll tell you what though, Cisco's only got little ears. Cisco, was that loud enough for you? No, it wasn't. I'll tell you what, we need a little bit more energy. On the count of three, let's say it one more time, a little bit louder, and hopefully we can get Cisco to jump and touch the boy. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Good job, Cisco. And a free shower for the front row and the little girl in the bucket hat as well.
Elephant. pelican. Peacock. Capybara. Gorilla.
Now this is Slammer, and even with his beak and feet, he needs help to get inside an emu egg, and the rock is the perfect tool for the job. Now what you're witnessing is not something Slammer was ever taught to do, it's instinct, and he hatched from his own egg with this knowledge already in his brain. Now he has made a small hole, and if this was a real emu egg, it now becomes easy
Hulk.
To get into, as they are designed to be broken from the inside out. But our plaster eggs, oh, are just that little bit tougher, take a bit more persistence to get inside. Let me try again. Oh, swing and a miss. Now they will not limit themselves to emu eggs. In fact, any egg will do. If the egg is small, they'll just pick it up and throw it at the ground. But the emu egg is so big, this is the only possible way he could have ever hoped to get inside. Get a chook egg or something and the first hit, you think, geez, that's quite strong. But as soon as it's just got any fracture in it, it becomes a lot easier to get inside. And it's really worth it for the buzzard to get in there, because there is close to 2 days' worth of food inside this hard shell. And the instincts are so strong that they too persist until they get inside. Oh, that's a nice shot. I think you're going to have to hit it a few more times before you'll have success. Try again. Now this is probably one of Australia's least well-known birds of prey, and it's not because of a good double whammy. It's not because they're an endangered bird, but they do occur in naturally small numbers. They tend to occur in relatively dry, remote portions of the country, so they're just not a bird many people stumble across. So they tend to just occur on those river courses, often temporary water sources, and these type of situations through the arid inland is fairly few and far between, so it means these birds just occur in relatively low densities. Now, if you've spent any time around Alice Springs, they do breed along the Todd River there, but only seasonally when conditions are favourable. How are we going? That's all right. If it's too hard, Slammer, I can give you a hand. Let's see another hit. Give it a shot. So his instinct says that hole means I should get in. So he's trying to pull it apart. Doesn't quite get that it isn't working. It says it should. You try that rock. You can see the piece of food I've got in there as well. That's it, stretch, nope. That's it, give it a shot. Oh, well, you're in all on your own. Great job, Slammer, success. That's a good old one, that one. Yeah, don't you have mice in your emu eggs at home? Now, we do tend to associate tool use like this with humans and other primates, and I think that's why it's exciting to see Slammer reach his goal. I think it goes to show that we have a lot more in common with birds than what many people first thought. Thanks. Now, Leslie is fairly obviously a vulture, and like many of her kind, she feeds by reaching deep inside dead animals to get to all the soft, juicy bits that are inside. Now, this is a pretty messy way of eating, but that is why she has developed this relatively bald head and neck. For any blood and guts that collects upon her skin when it dries in the sun, it will just flake on off and, oops, careful, and she will get to stay extremely clean and healthy. Now, this is really important because vultures are facing enormous pressures all around the world. Some species have declined by as much as 99% in the last 10 to 15 years alone. And this has meant that diseases that impact on people are on the increase, things like anthrax and rabies. Now, we may not have vultures here in Australia, but we have many scavenging animals
that
achieve similar roles, things like ibis and ravens, even our eagles, just to name a few. Vultures are often got bad reps, but without them we'd be in a lot more trouble. And it's a big part of why we have so many flies here in Australia as well. They're also helping play that role of cleaning up creatures that are dead. If we don't look after them, they could easily, you're gonna get, just disappear. Let me give you a hand. Ready? Can you keep on heading? That a girl, off you go. They are a spectacular bird.
Cockatoo. Llama. Goat.
Washington and gentle folks about him. They say he's grown so tarnal proud he will not ride without them.
Yankee Doodle, keep it up.
Echidna.